Hey, it's Emmanuel here. In this video, we're going to take a look at credit cards, in particular, frequent flyer credit cards, how they work, what you should look out for, and how I use them to fund my travels using my reward points. Now, before we get started, I want you to know that this video is sponsored by American Express. So thank you for watching and thank you for your support. Of course, to fully understand credit cards, we have to delve into some history with credit mechanisms going back thousands of years, but we'll skip to the 1900s to get started. In the 1920s and 1930s, we can see the first types of credit cards in the form of a charge coin. Now, a charge coin was a metal coin which had an imprint of a number on it, and particular stores could then use this number to charge the customer's account for the purchases they made. Now, of course, because it was just an account number, often there was cases of mistaken identities and a little bit of fraud here and there, so this system wasn't ideal. Later on, we see stores developing what was called a charge plate. Now, those plates had the name and number of the account embossed into them, so then the stores could put them through this machine and imprint them on a piece of paper, and then later bill the customer at the end of the month. Now, in 1934, American Airlines pioneered the first ever travel credit card, which was only to be used with their airline, and it pretty much resulted in a 50% of their revenues coming from this particular card. Up until that time, only charge cards were available, so this meant that customers had to pay the balance in full at the end of the month. Now, airlines started to tap into this and offering credit cards where customers could pay back their travel expenses over a certain amount of time. Now, it's not until the 1950s when Ralf Schneider and Frank Namara, the founders of Diners Club, invented the first credit card or charge card at the time. Those cards could be used in between different businesses and was controlled by a central company, that being Diners Club. Interestingly, it was American Express in partnership with IBM that invented the first ever plastic credit card like we know it today. Now, at the time, IBM was working on a security feature for the CIA, and they implemented this across all cards. So now we know this as the magstripe. That was the first security feature they had on credit cards at the time. Not long thereafter, they also invented the ATM machine. So now people could withdraw their money from a machine using a plastic card. Pretty cool. Now, fast forward to today, and credit cards have come a long way, especially the rewards credit cards. But what exactly is the point of having a credit card, you may ask? Credit cards allow us to spend money now and pay it back later. While this is great in theory, it also allows people to go in debt and spend more than they can afford. For me, the only reason to use a credit card is, of course, the rewards. While I'm using the credit card and earning points on every dollar that I spend, my money is sitting in my account working hard for me. At the end of the month, I pay my bill in full to avoid any fees. At the same time, I'm also getting additional benefits and features that only a credit card can offer, such as fraud protection, insurances, etc. Now, let's talk about interest fees, because that's a big one and a lot of people get tricked up about it. Most of the rewards credit cards out there have a much higher interest rate per annum compared to the low interest credit cards that don't have a rewards program. But then you have to ask yourself, why is it that I am getting a credit card? Do I get it for the rewards, or do I get it because I want to spend more money than I can afford? For me, it's all about the rewards, and the annual percentage rate of interest doesn't matter because I'm paying my balance in full and on time. This avoids all the fees and gets me the maximum amount of rewards. Now, obviously, this all comes down to budgeting and personal understanding of your finances. This is something you need to learn over time, especially when it comes to frequent flyer credit cards. Paying your credit card on time and full, in theory, sounds very good. But in practice, there's always things in life that come our way that are unforeseen and where we might need to spend a little bit more and take a bit longer to pay it back. Now, the reason American Express is sponsoring this video is because they have a new feature called Plan It. Now, Plan It is a cash flow optimization tool that you can use for unforeseen expenses or for larger purchases where you want to pay it back in equal installments over 3, 6, 9, or 12 months. Now, with Plan It, you're not paying any interest, but they do charge a monthly fee. So when you're using the Plan It calculator, you can see upfront how much you're going to pay over a certain amount of time, so you know exactly what you're up for. I've done a complete overview and in-depth review of Plan It. I'm going to link the video down below, so if you want to check it out and learn more about Plan It, you can do so. Now, let's talk about the fun stuff, of course, and that's the rewards points that we earn from our credit cards. For me, the main reason to use a credit card is the rewards points. Now, I'm earning points on every single dollar that I spend, and especially if you're using credit cards for your business expenses, it adds up really quick. Where those points end up funding my luxury travel goals throughout the year and saving me a lot of money in the process. Frequent flyer points can be used for a variety of things. For me personally, flying is the most valuable perk that frequent flyer points offer me. Now, let me give you an example of exactly what I mean. Now, let's say, for example, a flight to Europe costs $6,000 in business class or 130,000 points one way. Now, if we take those same points, there might be certain items in online shopping malls that we can use our points on. For example, a toaster. Now, if a toaster costs 70,000 points and a business class flight costs 130,000 points, where you're getting a value of 6,000, the toaster might only have a value of $50. So therefore, if you're using 70,000 points on a toaster, you're essentially using $3,000 worth of value on that product that's only worth 50. That's something you have to consider when you're using your points, is to get the maximum amount of value, especially to you, because it's all personal in the end. Some people might like to use their points for a toaster, while others like to have the little bit of luxury when they're flying next. Now, a question I get asked often is, how do I get all these points? Because essentially you have to look at it this way. Spending $1 equals 1 point, roughly. Now, to get 130,000 points, you essentially need to spend $130,000. So the easiest way to get started in the points game, or to maximize the points that you have, is to look for sign-up offers from credit cards. Now, if you're new to American Express, you can take advantage of some incredible offers. Some of them offer you as much as 120,000 points just for taking on the card, meeting the minimum spend requirements, and then everything on top of that is a bonus. So I'll put a link down below and you can check out all the latest offers for credit card sign-up bonuses that are available in the market right now. So you can take advantage and kickstart your points earning goals. Now, if you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and let me know in the comments, which credit cards do you have currently? How many do you have? And do you prefer more rewards or a lower interest fee? I'm curious to know. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.